Buildings are full of potential to make people happier and healthier. They're full of potential to help the planet as we cut carbon, cut energy and water waste. Net positive buildings would drive so many really important outcomes. It's an invitation for us to unlock our creativity. Let's enable the building to become like a neural network where all of the operating systems talk to each other, keeping that air healthy and clean inside that building, making it so that you're always comfortable in that building. It's a vibrant, healthy, thriving place, organic, agile, flexible, and guess what? You're gonna be smarter and more productive too. This is the future we can realize. So let's look at the big picture. Buildings represent almost 40% of global greenhouse gas emissions. 75% of that is in operating the building. 25% is in building it to begin with. Buildings right now are largely just a burden on the balance sheet. They're a challenge for the planet and not good for profitability either. You gotta ask yourself, can't we do better? I'm Katie McGinty. I'm Chief Sustainability, Government and External Relations Officer at Johnson Controls. We're at an inflection point where the old way of both making and operating and running buildings is beginning to give way to the much better model. We have technology now to make the construction much greener. We can recycle steel and cut the carbon in that steel by almost 80%. When we redevelop properties, we're recycling, reusing materials. On the operating side, we'll be efficient. Let's totally electrify building. We can deploy heat pumps, for example. What do? They can heat and cool simultaneously. When it cools a room, it pulls the heat out, but instead of throwing that heat away, it puts it to work in creating hot water. Putting data and digital systems to work is the real game changer for buildings. We have meters and sensors that can very precisely tell us, hey, the refrigerant is low in the HVAC. Why don't you fix and repair that? The building can become like a battery, able to actually speak to the grid and sell energy back to the grid so that we can supercharge our ability to electrify transportation and the economy and pull the carbon out. We can paint a picture that is very compelling. Yes, it's about doing the right thing and tackling climate change. It's about helping your bottom line by cutting your energy costs, but it's about so much more. It's about a school district in Colorado that's saving $1 million a year as they cut their carbon 25%, and then investing that back so the kids have the best education. It's about the hospital that sliced its energy bill 50%, but employed digital sensors that also detect and destroy germs in that hospital so the patients get well quicker. Government and policymakers have a critical role to play. Right now, we have policies and incentives in place that are providing grants and upfront resources to enable building decarbonization projects to get going. We also see incredible partnerships between the public and the private sector, where we are pooling our finances, our technology, and our expertise, and then guaranteeing very significant carbon and energy savings. A lot of times we have an idea that if it's good for the environment, it must be bad for the economy. But I think we are unlearning that. We're at a very exciting point of change with buildings. I'm hopeful because we have the technology today to solve climate change. And when we get about tackling that problem as it relates to buildings, we unleash all kinds of potential because we're bolstering the bottom line. And it's going to enable us to demonstrate that what is good for the planet is pretty good for our profitability as well.